Now let's create a form-based application. Like our frame-based application, we will use the project wizard. This time, let's call our application HelloFormApp. Unlike the frame-based app project wizard, we specify a name for a form that will be part of our application. Let's call this form AppDisplayForm. As a result, .cpp and .h files with this name will automatically be created for us. After clicking through the remaining screen, we can now create our project. In addition to the pre-populated files we saw in the previous example, we also have the file appDisplayForm.cpp. The purpose of this is to instantiate our form from an XML file created in the UI Builder tool. Let's have a closer look at these files. In order to view the XML file, we need to open a Resource Explorer view for the project. To do this, we select Window, Show View, Other, then select Resource Explorer. Then we double-click the IDF AppDisplayForm XML file. Here is what the default form looks like in the UI Builder. On the right is a list of the other controls that we can drag and drop onto the form. The lower region of the screen has a Properties tab showing the configurable parameters of the form and the button shown. Pay particular attention to the IDs of the form IDF AppDisplayForm and the button IDC button OK, as we will use these in the code to access these controls. The onAppInitializing method is called during the initialization phase of the application. Here we can see the form pointer object being created from our form, which was created in the UI Builder. Here we obtain a pointer to our application frame to assign the frame control of the form we have created. We set this form to be the frame's current form and call the draw and show methods on the form to reveal it. When an AppDisplayForm object is constructed, no action is performed in the constructor. However, when we call initialize, utilizing two-phase construction, we construct our form using the XML file produced in the UI Builder tool. We do not need to specify the full path to this file, nor are we required to provide the XML extension. The onInitializing method is called by the application framework when a control has been successfully added to a container. In this case, the control is the form and the container is the application's frame. In this function, we initialize the button contained on the form. Having obtained a handle to it, we can set a unique action ID to identify it when selected and also inform the application framework that this object will implement the onActionPerformed event listener. Here we can see the implementation of the onActionPerformed method. When the button in the form is pressed, we simply display a log statement. Now let's compile and execute the code. Once it's compiled, we can run the application by selecting the Badder simulator icon. This automatically launches the simulator. When it is loading, you will see the form that was created with the UI Builder being constructed. When we select the button, we can see the log created in the application runtime output view. Now we'll import a form-based example from the SDK that will create multiple form views and show you how to switch between them and manage individual controls on each. The File Explorer example shows how we can navigate files and folders. In this example, the method addForm is used to create two forms, a list view form and a file view form. Each form will be responsible for its own initialization and control management. Here we can see the form-based application executing. This is just one of a number of examples available in the SDK, and there will be further updates and technical walkthroughs available. So please keep checking the website. Thank you for watching.